Hello friends, so we'll be studying today the LC matching network using Smith chart. So in this LC matching network, any given load can be matched using lumped element, which can be combination of L and C or C and C or L and L depending upon the given problem. So if the normalized load is inside 1 plus jx circle, then we have to use this circuit. In this circuit, the first element will be parallel with the load impedance and the second element will be in series. So if the load is inside 1 plus jx circle, the normalized load is inside 1 plus jx circle, we'll be using this circuit. And if the normalized load is outside 1 plus jx circle, then we'll be using this circuit. What is the difference between these two circuits? In the first circuit, the first element is parallel with the load impedance and second element is in series. In the second circuit, first element is in series and the second element is in shunt. So first of all, we have to choose which circuit is going to be used. Okay, so for that we must know where is 1 plus jx circle in Smith chart. So I'll be showing you 1 plus jx circle. Most of you are already aware of that. So basically this circle is 1 plus jx circle. So the circle which is passing through the center is called 1 plus jx circle. Just highlighting this. So this circle is 1 plus jx circle. Suppose your load value is the normalized load value is inside this circle, then you will be using the first circuit. If the normalized load value is outside this circle, then you will be using second circuit for the matching network. Okay, now come back to the circuit. Here, after solving using a Smith chart, you will have four possibilities. You will solve for B and X. Capital B and capital X are the susceptance and reactance. Similarly here, capital X is reactance and capital B is susceptance. And a small b is normalized susceptance and a small x is normalized reactance. What is normalized susceptance and reactance? You can see here. The normalized susceptance is the normalized value of susceptance. How will you normalize susceptance? If you divide it by characteristic admittance, you will get the normalized susceptance. So either you divide it by characteristic admittance or multiply with characteristic impedance, you will get normalized susceptance. Similarly, to get normalized reactance, you have to divide reactance by characteristic impedance, given characteristic impedance. So you will be getting V, small b and small x, that is normalized susceptance and reactance after solving using a Smith chart. So there are two possibilities. For susceptance, it will be either negative or positive. Similarly, for X, it will be either negative or positive. Let us assume that B is negative. B is negative means susceptance is negative. So any of the susceptance, if it is negative, it is going to give you inductance. And if it is positive, it will give you capacitance. So susceptance is negative means it is L and susceptance is positive means it is C. Similarly, if reactance is negative, it will give you capacitance and if reactance is positive, it will give you inductance. And the corresponding formula I have written here. So you can also derive by yourself. It's L equal to Z0 by 2 pi f B. If you are getting a negative susceptance, then it will be inductance and the inductance value can be calculated by using small b Z naught and given frequency. Similarly, these are the formulas for corresponding susceptance or reactance. Let us take a problem and then we will solve it. So let us assume that ZL is given as 60 plus 90 J ohm and the characteristic impedance Z naught is given as 50 ohm for given frequency of 300 megahertz. Alright. Now, first of all, we have to normalize the load. If I normalize it, what we will get? The normalized value of load is given by small ZL, that is equal to 60 divided by 50, 1.2 plus 1.8 J. So you need to decide by seeing the real part whether it is inside 1 plus JX circle or outside 1 plus JX circle. So if you see this 1 plus JX circle inside, all the values will be having, the real part will be more than 1. Because this 1 plus JX circle is exactly R equal to 1. So inside this R is greater than 1, outside this R is less than 1. So our point lies inside 1 plus JX circle. So identify that point. It is 1.2. 1.2 is here. 1.2 plus 1.8 J. So your point will be here. Right. So this is 1.2 plus 1.8 J. Next. So we have to use the first circuit. So we are going to use this circuit, means the first element should be susceptance and second element should be reactance. So our desired circuit should be this way. ZL. And this is the line which need to be matched, and this is your matching network. So in this we have to find the value of JB and JX. So for that, first of all we have to make a rotated 1 plus JX circle. That means we need to work on admittance chart. So this is basically impedance chart. So you have to make a rotated 1 plus JB circle. For that we have to identify the center. So this is center and we'll draw the rotated 1 plus JB circle. So it is drawn now. Next, we can see ZL is in parallel with the JB. That means we need to invert this ZL to get the admittance and then we can directly add with JB. So for that purpose, we have to invert this. So measure this length from the center. This length, and we have to take in the opposite side and draw a straight line from the ZL which is passing through the center. This is load point which is passing through the center. So your cutting point is here. So we can read it. What is the cutting point? It is around 2.26 and 0.4J. So this we can write as 0.26 minus 0.4J. Now we have to move on constant resistance circle, means this one is constant resistance circle. We are moving on. By moving constant resistance circle, we have to reach other side, this point, or we can also reach this side, which is very near to close to each other. So first we will solve for one side, then we can solve for other side also. So if I move to this side, we will be getting 0.26 plus, what is the value? It's 0.48. 0.48J. So obviously if you move this side, you will get 0.26 minus 0.48J. Okay. So first of all, you take this value and then we'll work out. So how much you need to add to get 0.26 plus 0.48J? So your initial value is 0.26 minus 0.4J. And final value is 0.26 plus 0.48J. So difference will give you the value of normalized susceptance. So normalized susceptance B equal to 0.48J minus 0.4J, which will be equal to 0.88J. That means the B value, B is 0.88, which is a positive value. That means it is going to give you a capacitance. Okay, so now we have reached at this point, and from there you have to go to opposite side to reach on 1 plus JV circle, original 1 plus JV circle. So what you need to do, again you need to draw a line which is passing through the center of the Smith chart and this point. So just draw this line like this. So it will cut somewhere at the original 1 plus JV circle. Read that value. That value is 1 plus 1.45, which is in between this. So 1 plus 1.45J. So from here, if you want to reach center so that it will be matched, so you have to follow this path and from here you have followed this path already. Okay, so now you will be reaching to the center and your current value is 1 plus 1.45J, and if you reach center it will become 1 plus J0. That means you are adding negative reactance in this to make 0. So the negative reactance value, that is X, will be equal to 0 minus JX, you write 0 minus J1.45, which is equal to minus J1.45. So the susceptance is positive, it's going to give you capacitance. And from there, you have reached this side. Sorry, this will be a negative value. Okay. So, what we will get here? We will get a value of 1 minus 1.45J. So, 0 minus J1.45 equal to plus J1.45. So, the X is positive, that is equal to 1.45. So these two value, using these two value, you can find the corresponding capacitance and inductance. And you already know the formula. What is the formula for these two things? So your B is positive. So you have to use formula C equal to z naught is given by 50 divided by 2 pi into f 3 into 10 to the power f is 300 megahertz, so 3 into 10 to the power 8, and b you have got is 0.88. so this will be c, which you can calculate. Similarly, L can be calculated as, because L is also, X is also positive, so this can be calculated as 1.45 multiplied by 50 divided by 2 pi into 3 into 10 to the power 8. So this will come in approximately picofarad and nanohenry. You can calculate by yourself and get the answer. Now we'll talk about the second solution. If somebody take this side, this was the first solution, and this will give you the second solution. So if you reach this side, because if you are inside 1 plus JB, JX circle, if you go opposite side, you will be inside the 1 plus JB circle. So one side, if you go, it will be a positive, okay, and if you go other side, you will get a negative value. That means the difference between these two is going to be negative. So if you calculate that, what you will get is B equal to minus 0.08. So B will be minus 0.08. Now if you are here, and from this you have to go again, convert it to impedance chart. So if you take the opposite point, this side you will reach at 1 plus, just opposite to this. So 1 plus 1.45. So in this case, JX will be minus 1.45J. So both value are negative. So if you see, B is negative means inductor, and X is negative means capacitor. So that means the first circuit will be inductor, first element will be inductor, second element will be capacitor. So I'll be making the circuit for first solution. First solution circuit will be like this. And for the second circuit, you have capacitor first, capacitor here and inductor here. Solution 1, solution 2. Thank you.